Hello and welcome everyone, Tiberius here, and today I'm going to show you how to use my new Burp extension, Copier. Copier is a free extension for both Burp Suite Community and Professional Editions, aimed at making report writing just a little bit less annoying. If you're a bug bounty hunter or pen tester like me, you probably copy requests and responses into reports, showing customers exactly how to exploit a particular vulnerability, or to use them as evidence a vulnerability exists. Requests, however, can contain quite a lot of text. This, of course, includes cookies, but also headers added by the browser, which aren't necessarily required by the server, the most notorious being the sec headers. In some cases, requests or even responses may have sensitive data we do not wish to put into reports. What usually ends up happening is we edit the requests to either remove or redact data we don't want to appear. Copier aims to automate this process, allowing users to define sets of match and replace rules for both requests and responses. Users can then preview the modifications being made before copying. Although I created Copier and am therefore biased, I can honestly say I use it on every single web app pen test and it saved me so much time. I truly believe it will make your reporting more efficient too, so please check out the link in the video description and continue watching to learn how to install and configure it. Please also remember to give the video a like, and if you want to see more of my content, subscribe and enable notifications. Okay, so installing Copier is actually pretty easy. What you want to do is go to github.com/tiberius/copier. A link will be in the description. And then you can either download the source code and compile it yourself. It's pretty easy. What I recommend though is going over here to releases. And then the current version is 1.1. So just click here, copier-1.1.jar. And that should download it. And then what you want to go and do is open up Burp Suite. And you're going to go to the extensions tab and you're going to click add. It's a Java extension, so that's good. Now we just need to find the jar file. So here it is for me. And then click next. And you probably won't see this when you start up. This is just because I have installed this before. But ignore this. This is fine if this output doesn't come up. It shouldn't give any errors, obviously, but what you should see is this new Copier tab. And this is basically the Copier settings. This is where you configure absolutely everything. So the first thing to note is this thing called profiles, all right? So the idea with Copier is you define a set of rules which apply to requests and or responses, but that doesn't necessarily mean you want all these rules to apply, right? You might have situations where you only want a few of these rules to apply. And so the easiest way to sort of deal with this was to create profiles. The idea being you can have a set of rules like for default, but then maybe you have another profile which has three of the four rules that you have, right? So for example, there might be an instance where you want to remove or truncate cookie values by default. But there might be instances where you want to preserve the cookies. So generally speaking, what I have is I have a default profile which removes cookies or at least truncates them. And then I have effectively a kind of a copy of it which doesn't do that. So it will just leave the cookies alone. It won't change them at all. But let's add a new profile. I'm just going to call this Tiberius. Click add here. And so now you see we can switch between profiles. Nothing's happening because obviously there aren't any rules defined by default. But let's switch to the Tiberius profile and we're going to add a new request rule, a request copy rule. So I'm going to click add here. Now, there are a few things obviously enabled by default. Location is where you want the match and replace to occur. So generally speaking, you know, there are quite a few options here. Request just means literally search the entire request. Request line is the first line, basically, you know, get/http 1.1, for example. So the very first line of the request is the request line. You can then limit it to URL parameters. Okay, so that would be, for example, ID equals 1. That would be the entire parameter, so the name and the value. You can limit it to parameter name. You can limit it to the parameter value. Request headers is the entire header block, not including the request line. So this is basically the entire header block as its single chunk. Or you can limit it to a single request header. Again, that's both the name and the value. Alternatively, you can do just the name, just the value, and then request body, right? It's the entire body of the request. If the body has parameters, and that doesn't matter if it's JSON parameters, if it's form parameters, etc. It should work for all of these. You can do parameters as individual parameters, or just the name, or just the value. So in this example, we're going to remove those sec headers. So in this case, really, I just want to do request header. Okay, and the idea, I could actually select request header name. It really doesn't matter. But actually, you know what? Let's do request header name. So the request header name, we want to match, and we're going to use regex. I'm just going to say, hey, match any request header names that start with sec. And I do want to put a dash in there. So sec with the dash, that's how those headers start. Then I'm going to put a period and an asterisk, which is going to select the rest of the line. Okay, so the rest of the name. And then we're just going to leave this blank. We're going to replace it with absolutely nothing. We're going to enable regex. It doesn't need to be case sensitive. Let's leave a comment though. Removes sec headers. And then we're going to click add. So we're matching the request header name, and we're going to match the entire name, right? So you might think, oh, well, that's just going to effectively remove the header names and leave us with just the value. But Copier is pretty clever. It will always at least try to create a valid request. So what should happen, even though we've basically told it to delete the entire header name, when it's rebuilding the requests, it should actually just remove the entire header. So let's have a look at how that goes. We're going to go to the proxy here. I'm going to click on the example.com request. So you see we have all these lovely sec headers. Okay. But if we click on this copy request window, it's defaulted to Tiberius. Default won't appear there because there are no rules. But you'll notice how now all the sec headers are gone. If I click back to raw, here they are. Go back to copy request, all the sec headers are gone. Now, I have a few options here. I can just copy the request like that and paste. And there you go. Again, no sec headers. What I can also do is I can copy the request and the response. And again, we scroll up. No sec headers. And the final option, I can basically include the URL. This is kind of useful. I find myself clicking this quite often. This is where you want the URL before the request to appear. So let's just copy the request again. And there you go. There's the URL. The other way of doing it is you can right click on the request, go to extensions, copier, and then choose one of the options, request response, request, or response there. So let's just copy the request again. This option doesn't have the include URL, but there you go. Okay, let's add a response rule now. And let's say I want to truncate cookie values. So we clicked add over here, and I'm going to go to response header, and I'm going to say, okay, we want set cookie, should probably do starts with set cookie, and we want to replace this with set cookie, and let's just do dot dot truncated like that. Regex as well, that's fine. Again, if you disable this, it'll just match literally. But now we can say let's truncate cookies. Okay, add that. Now if we go back to the proxy, well, this request didn't have any cookies, but I know for a fact this one to google.com does. So it has a bunch of set cookies down here. We go to copy response and scroll down. We see all these set cookies have now been truncated. Now what you can do if you're clever, and I do have an example of this which I'll show later, you can add a separate rule. These rules are processed one by one in order, which is why you have these up down buttons here. But what you can do is you can create a rule after this set cookie which will basically merge all those three headers. So you have, instead of having set cookie truncated three times in a row, you can potentially just replace those with one. Okay, so the other thing is this is currently not saved. All right, we've set it up, but if I was to restart Burp, these would all be gone. So what you really want to do is you want to make sure you go down to the persistence menu here and you click save. That will save it to Burp's internal preferences. If you press the reset button now, it should blank it. But don't worry, because we just click save, as long as we click restore, it should get restored. And at this moment, We have to actually change to Tiberius, okay? So don't worry if it blanked it technically. I did restore the Tiberius profile, which is what we've been operating under. The other thing is we can export the current profiles to a JSON file. So everything can be exported. So let's have a look at how that works. We go to export. I'm going to go copier here. Let's just do profiles.json. Save. And now let's open those files. So you can actually edit these profiles within the profiles.json file and then import them again. It's pretty simple, to be honest. This is the default profile, which obviously has no request rules or responses. This is the Tiberius profile, which has one request rule and one response. You can make modifications here, or you can share them, you know, with friends or publish them on GitHub, etc. So that's how you do that. Now let's import the copy profile that I use on my regular job. So I have downloaded the file and I'm going to open it here. So I usually obviously use my default profile. I've got the removes headers that start with sec. I've got various other removing headers I don't really like. I've got cookie truncation. I've got authorization bearer redacted, so redacting bearer tokens. In response rules, I have some set cookie stuff, getting rid of server headers, a bunch of things here. This is the set cookie multiple truncation thing I was telling you about. So as you can see, you can get some pretty advanced regex going on. But let's import this now. And there we go. So again, this regex, what it does, it should, if we go back to that Google example and now scroll down, you'll see we only have one set cookie as opposed to three. Now I also have default accept cookies. So effectively what that does is it does all the regular match and replace except for the cookies. So I can go back here and I obviously need to select default accept cookies here and default accept cookies here. There's a few things I should probably fix, but basically the cookies are back. And here as well. And the final one is truncate response. So there are some instances where I want to basically remove everything and also truncate the response to like 200 characters, right? Say I want to copy the response, but I'm only really interested in the first 200 characters of it. So that's what this one does. If I select truncate response, you'll see it truncates everything. Now, what's important to note is the content length remains the same. Okay, that makes sense because that is the actual content length. This has just been truncated for copying. If you don't want that to happen, you can click update response content link header. Or if you're doing it in the request, you can do that. So if you're making any changes to the body, you can always enable these and then it will literally should. Yeah, there we go. Reduce it to 217. But you probably don't want to do that. Most of the time, you'll probably want, and I put that in most cases, that should be left disabled. Thanks for watching. Once again, links to Copier are in the video description. If you have any questions about the extension or how to use it, please leave a comment or create an issue over on GitHub. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and consider enabling notifications. Until next time.